dad was always in and out of my life for as long as I could remember. He'd come back, stay a while, then go back to jail. And so finally around like 6 or 7, he moved away. So it was just me, my sister, and my mom living together in our house. She, I learned later, was struggling with her own drug addiction problem. I can remember boiling water to take a bath in the sink because our hot water, our gas was shut off and our electricity was shut off. You get used to it. I thought that was normal. Eventually, the state came in. They called my grandma here and asked her, you know, we got these two kids. We could put them into foster care. Do you want to take them in? Thankfully, she took us in. She asked me, you know, what do you want to do? I want you involved in an activity. And I told her I wanted to race. A family friend said, why don't you come watch my son race? We have a local race in town. It's a big go-kart race. Why don't you come watch him race go-karts? So we did, and that's where we met Roger, who's my mentor. He built my first go-kart. And one thing led to another, and here we are 7 years later still doing the same thing.
I've been racing sprint cars for better part of the last 40-some years. It's just like a big family. And when I go to the racetrack, I do it for fun because I know I'm not going to ever go to NASCAR or IndyCar. When I was younger, that was my dream. When I go to the racetrack, I see people that I haven't seen for a week, and they're friends. We might park next to our biggest rival, and we might want to beat him so bad, but when it gets down to the end of the night and he needs a shock, we're letting him borrow one of our shocks. And he does the same for us. I really put in my mind that somehow I'm going to figure out a way to win this race every time I hit the track. And that's what I see in Tyler Nelson. I've observed him many times. And, you know, I've watched him work on the guy in front of him and manipulate his car to where in the next corner he'll have a little bit of an advantage.
When I was originally called owner to come videotape for them, I'll never forget my first Friday night out there and stuff. I went back to the pits, and what I thought at that time was a little kid came up to me and shook my hand and asked me how I was doing. And during that conversation, I asked him, I said, so what are you doing? He says, well, I drive a car, and he pointed back to this little sprint car. And I just thought at that time, you know, number one, how could this little kid drive a car like that? And then number two, I was just so impressed with this young man that came up and shook my hand and asked me how I was doing, never seeing me before. I've always been very impressed with Tyler, driver. He hasn't taken any chances that's going to do any harm to him or to any of the other drivers. It's amazing how Tyler has decided to go down this road when he very easily could have went down this road. And I think he's got a very good head on his shoulder. I think he is very focused, and he knows right from wrong, and especially now with his dealings with the Boys and Girls Club, I think he's got a very bright future in front of him.
Two and a half, 3 years ago, out at Valley Speedway, it was the opening night of the season. And I won my race in the micro sprint, which was the first division out that night. And then in the sprint car race, there was a bad wreck, I think on the last lap, and a driver lost their life. His name was Jeff Osborne. And you know, when you're at the same racetrack as that and you see somebody lose their life to something you love doing, it really moves you. And I decided to donate my purse that night to the family. And actually a family friend said, why don't we do something more for this family? Because my purse that night was $300. And he said, you know, every dollar helps, but $300 isn't going to go that far. Let's do this right and get them enough money to actually do something. So we put on a fundraiser. We raised $2,400 for the family and donated that to them. And I really just became inspired by that. And I said, why don't we go further? Why don't we make this an actual thing to help people in the community, not just stop here? The Boys and Girls Club took interest because You know, it was a nonprofit headed by a 15-year-old kid at the time. So my story of coming from that background and turning it around and turning it into positives for others really fit in there. So I started going and speaking to the clubs, and that's why they named me their Goodwill Ambassador and the official spokesperson.
We do a feature every week on people. People who do great things, people around sports, not just the people who cross the finish line first, not just people who win the trophies, but people who make a difference. Sometimes that can be a scorekeeper, sometimes it can be a great young man like Tyler. Anything that makes the sports experience better. And Tyler makes sports better not just because he has a passion for what he does, but also because he's interested in giving back and he's such a young man. And he experienced so many negative things in his life that he is trying to turn into a positive for other people. I'm always looking for someone who does make a difference, and Tyler fits that.
Tonight's Events Memorial Stone in honor of Howard Lehman. I just run 31 laps. I just wanted to say.
You know, I just want to make a career out of racing and use racing as a vehicle to do well in the community and to help others. Whether that be, you know, a career in NASCAR, IndyCar, driving professionally, or if that's just driving a sprint car for a team professionally, whatever that is, I just would love to make a living racing and just use that as a power to do good in the community. It's really not important if I accomplish that. The important thing is that I have that dream and I can keep striving for it. Starting the first of the year in January, I'll be making my first trip to the Chili Bowl, which is the biggest race in midget racing. Every midget in the country will be there. It's truly the Indianapolis 500 for midget racing. So I'm really excited for that. It's indoors in Tulsa, Oklahoma. They built a quarter mile track inside.
As far as sponsor backing, it's beneficial to people to sponsor race cars, because there's a lot of ways that it pays them back. And number one, their cars are seen at the track by thousands of people a weekend. You know, if your name's on the side of a trailer, people see it up and down the road every day. A lot of people do it just because they enjoy auto racing. You know, the payback is that you're watching, especially with these younger kids, you're watching this kid start and you're helping to further his career. You know, when I see like a kid like Tyler, and you know, I'd hate to see him somehow lose that dream. I'd like to see him pursue that to the farthest he could go, and with financial support of sponsors and the like, he can do that. But without that, you know, it's going to be difficult.